Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, welcome to a map tour on a map called Felsbrunn 2022. Now, if you remember with Felsbrunn, the map came out originally for FS19. It was I believe it was a base game map. But I want to thank all my return subscribers to the channel as your love and your support to this channel that has made this channel grow to be where it is today. And then, secondly, I want to wish any new subscriber on the channel or anyone that's coming to watch this video the first time, welcome. This is some of the stuff that I do on the channel. If you guys are interested in seeing this kind of content, as well as some other content, get subscribed to the channel and tap that notification bell and hit a like on a video. And we will see you guys real soon. Now let's get into this. This is, like I said, this is a map tour of Felsbrunn 2022. So I can't wait to do this. And hold on. Hopefully we didn't hear anything with the music there. If we did, oh well. We'll always edit that out. So. Alright, so. Takes a little bit of process just to load up, but how's everybody doing? I hope your Friday is well. Or I should say, I'm going to record this here, or record this on Friday, but I don't know when I'll release it. Maybe I'll release it tonight, or maybe I'll just release it tomorrow. I'm not sure yet. There's a few maps that I had to get through. Before I can do some other stuff. If you guys haven't already gone and seen my mod showcase video, video for the 26th of August, I recommend you go ahead and see that. It's got some crucial information. So we have what it looks like. The roadway is very familiar to what it is. There is a big field right here, which is exactly where it should be. Then I believe there's probably a pond or a lake right down there. Yep, there's a lake. So it's very similar to what it was. And then over here is our one of our sheds with our starting farm right here. We have a Fendt favorite 511C tractor with a twin Lincoln pack 7050 weight base game. And then we have the base game cedar, a Nordisting HK25 plus NS3030 cedar. And then we have a static house that has a sleep trigger that you can do with sleeping right over here. And then there's a bench that will allow you to open a wardrobe in case you want to change the clothes outside for some reason. I'm not sure what it is. And then we have a cat in the way. She comes available with all my tours and map tours. And then we have a lizard pickup 2017 in a storage shed kind of thing that looks like kind of like a makeshift garage. And then we have the workshop behind it, which allow you to open vehicle options and work on your trucks and combines and cedars and other cut that you may have. And then we have what looks like another shed with the header Dutzfar top liner 40. Hold up. Thanks, Katie. Then we have the Dutzfar top liner 4090 header trailer. And then we have a Massey Ferguson MF3670 tractor with the Walger DK115 trailer. And then I believe we probably have working automatic lights, maybe? Do we have some automatic lights? Turn on side lights. Okay. So you do have to click on the button right here to manually turn off and turn on your light system. We do have another shelter or another shed system right over here. The Rudolph Horman sheds, two of them right next to each other. And then we have a grain silo here, the Farm 800 plus OBI 1000 silo system. And then we have a Duke's Bar Combine, top 1 with the Ready to Rock and Roll. And then we have the Dupes are on the top 140 header with a weak field that they give you that tray of rock and roll. And then over here is another Dupes are or a Fent favorite 511C tractor with the Tenwinkle Pack 75 750. And then a RAM EG39 cultivator and rock and roll on this harvested field that was wheat and it's ready to harvest. So there's two fields right there. Let's see here. Do we have anything? And the two fields are standard also in FS19 as well. And then we have, well, let's go ahead and check out our find it. Do we have a custom crop town on there at all? I don't know. No, we do. These are all looking like they're standard crop calendar. So nothing new there. Now, okay, let's go ahead and start doing some buying of farmland and figuring out how much stuff would cost us over here in field 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right here, these five fields up in this area is very familiar. Back over here is very familiar. Everything's pretty familiar about this map. There's nothing new added changes or nothing. So let's go ahead and do field pricing and we'll go from there, yes? You're digging into me there, Kenny. So the first field, field number one, if you exclude the precision farming indicator, it would be, but in parentheses, it's $133,705 per hectare, but altogether, the value without the precision farming stuff would be $315,760 for field number one. Field number two would be $239,400. And then in parentheses on the precision farming stuff is $115,000 per hectare. And then field number three is $253,180. And then $159,192 per hectare. And then if we bought field number four, it's $393,700. And then $241,237. And then field number five would be $231,540. $241,590, and then over here, if we bought this area and you wanted to cut down this forest area, it's $281,880. If you wanted to buy this area, it's $511,480. And then if you wanted to get this area, it's $459,800 or $650. And then if we wanted to get this area, it's $325,060. Now, if we wanted to buy field number, if we go to field number six, it's $711,400. And in parentheses for precision farming values, it's $136,618. Now, if we wanted to buy field number seven, is $419,940 and $112,608. If we bought this area, it's $319,820. If we bought that area, it's $220,968. If we bought this area, it's $459,650. Now, if we bought field number eight, is $276,460 for the field. I cannot right now. So if we want to buy, if we want to be able to buy field number eight, it's $276,460. If we bought the precision and the precision farm value, of the field would be 107,975 per hectare. Now, if we wanted to buy field number 9, it's $243,220, and then the precision farming value of field number 9 would be $80,771 per hectare. If we wanted to buy field number 10, is $441,720. If we wanted to buy field number 11, it would be $160,540, and then the precision farming value of the field would be $75,314. If we wanted to buy field number 12, it would be $378,320. If we wanted to buy in the precision farming value of this field, it would be $367,475 per hectare. If we wanted to buy field 13, it's $253,920. If we wanted the precision farming value, it would be $62,290. If we bought field 14, it's $336,380. And the precision farming value would be $86,722 per hectare. Now, if we wanted to buy field 15, it would be $187,500. If we bought the precision value, would be $150,481. If we bought field 16, it's $504,060. And then if we buy the precision value of farming, would be $106,278. Now, if we bought this area, it's $131,020. If we bought field 17, it's $218,200. Precision farming value of field 17 would be $73,103 per hectare. If we bought field 18, it's $150,160, and the precision value of farming, the precision value of field 17 or 18 would be $78,208 per hectare. If we sold fields 19, we could get $125,540 back, and the precision value would be $91,167 per hectare. If we sold field 20, it would be plus our farm, it would be $151,640, and then the precision value of the field plus the farm would be $206,819. Now, if we wanted to buy field 21, it'd be $234,660, and then the precision value would be $97,775 per hectare. If we bought field 22, plus the lake area is $336,520. Precision value would be $88,223. If we bought field 23, it would be $372,360. And then the precision value would be $166,350. If we bought field 24, it would be $243,760. And then the precision value would be $184,946. If we bought field 25, it would be $132,340. And then the precision value would be $180,201. Then if we bought field 26, it would be $104,600. And then the precision value would be $91,433 per hectare. And then if we bought field 27, it would be $170,580. And then the precision value would be $99,359. If we bought field 28, it would be $89,580. And then the precision value would be $159,964. And then if we bought field 29, it'd be $94,200. And then the precision value would be $195,598. And if we bought field 30, it'd be 150,840, and then precision value would be 96,371. If we box field 31, it would be 186,040, and then precision value would be 118,406. If we box field 32, it'd be 167,660, and then the precision value would be 161,709 per hectare.
Good job, Kitty! You got him!
If you bought this whole area of 664,940, if you bought that area, it's $147,100. If we bought this area, it's $1,100,086. If we bought this area, it's $323,580. If we bought this area, it's $96,666. If we bought field 33, it is $226,440. If we bought this area, it is $242,440. And then if we bought field 30, let's see here. Field 34, it's $42,720. And then precision farming value of that field is $66,750. If we buy field 35, it's $68,840. And then precision value is $558,457. And then if we buy field 36, it's $40,320. And then precision value is $84,848. And then if we bought field 37, it's $102,699 and precision value $62,242. All right, so that concludes the field buying, and let's go ahead and see what else we got here going on. So do we have any precision farming stuff at all? So let's go back over here. So we have the soil fair. Aurora said, this must be like the train station. Ooh, collectibles. There's a few collectibles right here. There's a, looks like a trailer collectible. And then there is a plow collectible. And then right down here is a bucket of sorts. And then there is some... there is an access box that shuts off power and turns on power. And then there is what looks like another little bit of stuff around. Back up here, there is another collectible. Actually, there's five collectibles right here, so wow. That's crazy. Alright, let's go ahead and look at... let's see, the silo of our set, let's go to farming production output silo. So let's go right over here and buy it for $50,000. I think this is probably maybe bakery of sorts. I don't know. This could be a restaurant mode. But there's one waking trailer, a collectible right around here. There's a few other things as well. There is a combine harvester collectible. There is some more stuff around here, and then let's go right over to here is the grain mill. So let's go ahead and check out the grain mill. I'm sorry about the noise on the production piece, but you can buy it for $96,000. And then let's get right over here and see if we can find anything neat and fancy or whatnot. Any collectibles at all? Nothing that I can see anyway. Alright, so then we have the gas station. And then up here is the grain processing unit. So let's go ahead and check out the grain processing unit and see how much they want for this. $80,000. So that's not bad. We can get that pretty quickly. There's a sawmill right here, so this would be where we can sell wood. We have our trailer trigger, where we can dump wood chips. And then right over here is where we can buy it for 100,000, which is the same stuff. Another combine harvester collectible. Let's see here. So then we have the sawmill part. And then let's go down over here is the gas station. Over here is an oil mill. So let's go ahead and check out the oil mill. So let's go right up here and buy it for $80,000. So that's good. And then we have a sugar mill, which is right over here. That's $80,000. So wait, maybe hold up. Oh, the oil mill's over here. I was looking at the sugar mill earlier. My bad. Oil mill would be $80,000 too. So we can buy the oil mill and the sugar mill for both $80,000, as well as the grape processing unit. So port 02. Let's go ahead and check out port 02 and see what the port looks like. Some good stuff is happening over here. So let's go ahead and check out these bumpers up here and see if we can find anything that's a collectible or nothing. I'm sure there's a few collectibles. Oh, I love that. That's cool. A ship. Oh, that's an invisible barrier. Yep, that's okay. That's fine. And then we have the rent-a-train Strig Logger. I believe this is another train station, maybe? Yeah, it looks like another train station. Then we have the Horse Barn Large. Let's go check out Horse Barn Large. Let's go see if we can get any animals here. So we can get 14 horses from the Grays, Pintos, Palomino's, Chestnut, Bay, Blacks, Seal Brown, and Duns. Okay, so that's all cool. Then we have the animal dealer and the bail sale. We have our main farm right over here. Let's go to the Hooten Toggle Bar. This is another sell point, it looks like. And then we have a tailor shop. So let's check out the tailor shop and see what we can buy. For $100,000, we can get the tailor shop and the sawmill. And then let's go bakery. I think this is probably 50 or 60,000 probably for bakeries if I remember, because it's standard production stuff. So $50,000. Yep, I was right on that one. Rent a train supermarket right here. Let's go sell point. It's a sell point for a supermarket. You can load some stuff up. The Cassel Felsbrunn. Is this a cereal place? Or is this like a dairy place for $50,000? I think it's probably a dairy. Gas station spinnery. Let's check out the spinnery. We're going to check the spinnery out for $60,000 for the spinnery. Chocolatier. So this is a chocolatier that you can buy for $50,000, a hotel, and then a dairy. So right over here is a dairy, so you can drop off some stuff. You can drop it off at a sell point. You can go over here and buy for $70,000. And then, let's see, where are we right now? Okay, and then we got a port right here and a grain mill. So let's go visit the grain mill and see what we can get for the grain mill. Can we get anything? Maybe not. Okay, well, we can't get anything on the grain mill over here. So that probably that's probably gonna have to get fixed in the future update for sure. And then we have a lime station and a cereal factory. So let's go visit the cereal factory and see if we can access the purchase point for the cereal factory. $110,000, which makes sense. And then the Agri LB. So that's another sell point. That's all good. And then the Farm Production Plaster. Alright, let's check this out. Buy it for $50,000. So that allows us to do like paper factories and whatnot. Rent a train, debris crusher. Alright, I think I covered all of the production sell points on the map. So with that being said, I think I'm going to go ahead and quit the game and see, come on back through and check out Farm Manager and then start from scratch. Primarily what we're doing with Farm Manager and start from scratch mode in the mod or the map tour on this map is to basically look to see if we have an equipment. I know we're probably not getting fields in Farm Manager or start from scratch because we had to buy everything that way. In New Farmer, that's the only version where you start off with a farm and you get some fields and some equipment most of the time. There are some exceptions to the rule, but yeah, so you don't have any buildings, you don't have equipment, and you've got no fields either. Yeah, so that's Farm Manager. So, and you start off with here's a couple contracts if you're interested. Not that those contracts are fixed contracts, meaning they'll come out with these contracts with this price amount every single time. It's probably not going to happen. But you start off with $1.5 million and you go from there. And so I'm going to probably assume, and therefore, that start from scratch allows us, gives us the same similar setup. So we're going to go ahead and stop recording the map tour. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, get subscribed to the channel and tap that notification bell and hit like for me. And come on back for some more great content from in the future. All right, later. Peace.